Hey everybody, it's Phil with Behringer. How you doing today? Welcome to Music Studios. I want to talk to you today about the MOTÖR 49 and the MOTÖR 61 keyboards and how to set them up. These keyboards have so many cool things in them. I mean, really, you have three products in one. You have a MIDI trigger pad over here, and you have a transport control and faders that'll use Mackie Control mode, so you can control your favorite DAW with that. And it's so hip to be able to do panning and volume and things like that. And it's a MIDI keyboard, right? The setup is very important, and so this video is about how to set it up in Ableton Live. Okay, we did another one on Reaper and another one on Logic. We're doing like a whole series of them, and this one's about Ableton Live. So let's just get dialed in with the settings and have some fun. So in this video, I'm going to be working on the Mac. It works pretty much the same for PC, but this presentation, I'm going to be working with the Mac, okay? And so out of the box, you turn on the unit, whether it's the 49 or the 61. You turn it on, you connect the USB to your computer, okay? So that's the first fun part. We want to make sure that the computer actually sees it. So on the Mac, that's the audio MIDI utility. So as you can see right here on my screen, here's a MOTÖR 61 keyboard, and I see two ports here, okay? These two ports are super important, okay? Because port one is for MIDI and port two is for Mackie Control, and I'm gonna show you how to set that up. But if you can kind of get that kind of dialed in, that concept, which is pretty straightforward, we're gonna have a lot of fun. I'm gonna put the keyboard even in MC mode. In the operation mode, you have MIDI and MC mode, okay? The reason these two are important is MC mode is, of course, going to give you Mackie control modes for your DAW, which is going to bring you a lot of fun being able, like I said, to use the MIDI faders and things like that. If you're using a straight sequencer that cannot use Mackie control mode, like say GarageBand or something like that, where there's no capability for transport control, and it's a straightforward MIDI sequencer, then just stay in the MIDI mode and everything will work fine there. So as you can see on audio MIDI, I can see the MOTÖR 61 keyboard. That's a good place. So let's go ahead and just go on over to Ableton Live, okay? And let's go through the settings. So I'm gonna go to Preferences, and for Control Surface, I wanna use Mackie Control, and I wanna choose MOTÖR 61 keyboard port 2, okay? For both input and output, all right? So that's gonna give me my Mackie Control. And then for MIDI ports, I want to turn on MOTÖR keyboard port 1, okay? So then that's going to go ahead and give me keyboard access for the MIDI keys. So it's pretty straightforward. I go ahead and close that now. So now that I have my preferences all set up, now I can go ahead and just, I picked a nice Rhodes, and I'm in MC mode, and I have my nice... Right, so I have a nice Rhodes sound or whatever sound I want to go ahead and plug in. The keyboard is controlling it great. Now, what's fun to look at on the screen here is now if I go and I move the faders here, you can see the faders move in software. So I can move them up and down, and it's controlling it. It's using Mackie control, right? And the same thing with my pans. You can see I'm panning left, I'm panning right, panning left and right. So I have full control of my transport. If I hit play, you can see up here that the song is actually moving and it's playing. The light illuminates. So I have my Mackie control and I have my keyboard as a MIDI controller, which is super cool. So this is just the basic setup of how to get this happen to Ableton Live, how to do the setup. There's one other thing I want to show you. When you're doing your control setup, this page, there's a quick start guide that you can download at Behringer.com on either the product page for the MOTÖR 49 or the 61. It's the same document. And it's a quick start guide, okay? When you download that, this page 30 is super important, okay? Because in Mackie mode, these fader bank, encoder bank, and pad bank buttons are gonna operate differently than they're written on the front of the panel because they have to, because we're adhering to Mackie control protocol. So this page 30 is super important. You'll see on the left-hand side, it says fader banks, encoder banks, and what they're going to be actually doing in Mackie control mode, okay? So it's super important to pay attention to page 30 there. The other thing that's important is to choose the right ports for MIDI and for Mackie control. And then the rest of it is basically just have fun. So I hope this has been a cool little setup on how to get dialed in with Ableton Live. It's really kind of straightforward. You do have to pay attention to the details. I hope it's been helpful. For more information and media, you know you can come visit us at Behringer.com. Thanks for joining us here at Music Studios.